Lola was a dancing girl who started getting fat. Every day brought 2 more pounds to Ella. Until one day she found she lost her job because of that. Then to make it worse, she lost her fella. And so she sailed to Egypt to forget. But she made such a hit that she's there yet. If you hear of a gal who can shake and quake till it makes you think of a nervous snake, then you're speaking of Egyptianella. She weighs 220, but they don't care. They like 'em plenty that way out there and has the love of every fella. She does a dance with certain parts by the River Nile. The boys take all their old sweethearts and throw them to the crocodiles. And every sheik in the audience jumps up and yells that she's immense. How they love Egyptianella. All the other dancers from the desert to the Nile, one by one admit that they are jealous. For although they dance each night and wear their sweetest smile, Ella's tense the one that draws the fellas. And yet her dance is something they can't steal, for nothing else could do it but an eel. When the first sweet notes of the music sound, the boys gather from miles around just to see Egyptianella. And folks all know when the caravans start pouring in from the desert sands, it must be Egyptianella. Then Mr. Sphinx sits up and blinks, there's so much to see. She squirms and shakes, so the worms and snakes all bite themselves from jealousy. She's a great big gal in a great big land, and the boys all give her a great big hand. Now they love Egyptianella. She plainly states she doesn't care a fig about dates and how they can't make it with Egyptianella. She tried to kidnap her once, I'm told, but she shook so much he lost his hold. He couldn't take Egyptianella. So the Pasha wrote her a royal note with his royal fist. It said because of the dance she does, she's on his royal waiting list. And that's how fame of a different sort has come at last from an indoor sport to our own Egyptianella. Egyptianella, written in 1931. It's for the 119th season of the ukulele.